Kumusta kayong lahat? Welcome to Pinoy Crossover, guys, the basketball show for the Filipino community. It's your host for tonight, Marky Mark on the house. And on my right here, we got JR. How you feeling?
Good, man. I'm doing all right. How about you?
I'm doing awesome because here tonight, guys, special guests. I don't want to introduce them because I want them to introduce themselves. The champion of the Fil-Can Open basketball. Introduce yourself, some of the Fil-Act players and the coach.
Yo, what's up? Mark Zweedy, M-A-R-K-Z-W-E-T-I-E.
That was straight up, yo.
Good to be back. Second time on the show. You know, I'm just excited. Let's get it.
Yeah, last time he was here, he was at the season 3 finale, so thanks for coming back.
Yeah, good to be back.
Who you brought on, the MVP of that game.
So, Gene, so my name is Krishan Gandhi. Instagram, KCGKAYCGEE. Thanks for having me. Yeah, you know, I really appreciate it.
The cool thing is we didn't have them practice that. They knew that straight up from the heart. We didn't even, like, you know. And we're feeling good because we're going to go straight up to the champion. Tell us about, you know, the game. Like, because we broadcasted it live. We had, you know, me, JR, PJ, the camera crew from Filipino TV broadcasted the whole game. It was, a tight, great, epic ending. A great game in general.
Yeah.
Tell us, you know, a little bit about, I guess, you know, the anticipation before that game. Or just the whole story, kind of, in a sense.
You want to go,
Yeah. Take turns.
Oh, yeah. Okay. So, I don't know. First, like, I don't know. Yeah, with you guys being there broadcasting it, like, doing the live commentary, announcing the names at start, that really, like, it gave it a real championship game feel. And, like, just the game overall, we had two great teams. Like, we knew who the better team was, but it was two great teams. And, you know, close game overall. Like, yeah, we came out with a win. Shout out, Regine.
Yeah, it was a very hyped game because it was a full court Seneca. We usually play half courts, like, vertical.
Oh, the same gym.
Yeah, same gym. It's just cut in half, and then we play horizontal. It was a great game. There's a lot of hype going towards it. You guys hyped it up big time with Filipino TV, and I was just very excited because we knew it would be a very great task, like a hard task for us to do. Yeah. We came out with the win, and it was a great game.
Yeah. Plus, like, I know you guys mentioned a little bit that there was a history history behind these two teams, like behind you guys and the 25 for Life. Tell us a little bit about, you know, the history behind it, or, like, you know, the rivalry between you guys. I know you guys have some stories you want to share, so.
Well, I don't know, just going back, right? It's like everyone grew up Filipino League. We've been playing against Brandon, Jasper, and the rest of those guys. Mm-hmm. Like, since we were young, and just, like, to continue playing against them when we're open now, and to keep competing is just good.
Yeah, it keeps the competitive spirit alive. We actually used to be, like, all teammates when we were younger. Mm-hmm. We all just branched out. Like, and there's a whole history with Fil-Act and Fil-Can. Mm-hmm. So just to be able to represent Fil-Act and then be able to represent Fil-Can, it was great as a part of history and a continuing tradition.
Mm-hmm. I mean, maybe you want to mention, like, 25 for, like, they came in, like, a couple of them came to our show, actually, John and Mike. They told us about the history of 25 for Life, how it's, you know, it's one of the teams that everybody feared back in the day. It's the teams that everybody was going for to beat. Tell us, like, a little bit of history about Fil-Act. Maybe you guys have something you want to share to the, you know, people watching the show or the kids that are watching the show. A little bit of history about the Fil-Act basketball community.
Well, I don't know. Fil-Act as an organization started in 1969. Yeah. First Filipino league in Toronto.
Yeah.
Shout out to Tito Flor.
Tito Flor, rest in peace.
But, yeah, ever since then, it's like, everyone's been branching off since then, which is good because it creates more competition, makes everyone better. But yeah, just know who's the first.
And feel like, you know, that game was pretty good too. You guys were down a bit. How did you guys, like, came up about, you know, you guys need to come back in this game? And, you know, you guys were down, you know, through the second half, and you guys made a good comeback in the third quarter and fourth quarter.
I'll take this one. So pretty much just stay the course. Basketball is a game of runs. And we have a great coach in Mark. He kept us level-headed, kept us calm. We just knew that if we kept playing our game, playing our style, that things will go our way, and that's how it turned out.
Did you have a game plan in mind before, or that you guys prepared for, in terms of how you're going to beat the... Because they're pretty, you know, in terms of the lineup that they have and the players that they had, they're a pretty good team and a pretty hard team to beat.
Well, no, yeah, going in, like, you see Brandon, like, you know, he's the number one guy to stop. Like, you put four guys on him, he's still going to score inside the paint. So number one priority was to make sure Brandon doesn't get on fire, even though he did kind of. Like, he had that big three in the fourth.
But, that was big, yeah.
That was a big
but, yeah,
three.
Like, the game plan was just, like, make Brandon pass the ball and let everyone else try to beat us.
Mm-hmm. And I saw you guys, like, putting in, like, our boy Ray. And I know Ray was in the show a couple of weeks ago. You had him on Brandon, too, and I was like... The size difference, but he fought him through as well. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
No, that's what I like about our vets. Like, shout out Ray, shout out Chris. Like, these guys grew up in the 90s, right? So they have that scrappy defensive mm-hmm. mentality, and then that's what we really needed that game. So mm-hmm. Chris and Ray, they did good jobs in their minutes against Brandon, and then yeah, they really made him work.
And you talk about scrappy, you know, when I was watching and recording the game as well on the sidelines, I could see like the close-ups of how scrappy it was, like against with Ray, who came on the show a few weeks ago. He was guarding Brandon Ramirez on the top of the
like
key.
Like one-on-one, like no help too.
Trying to box him out. Like, where do you guys think that came from? Like, especially for you guys, Filipino basketball players or coaches, and that scrappiness and being so physical on the court, especially in that the open and the senior games too.
Well, I think for Ray, it helps him because like he grew up in Scarborough, right? So like we're tough down there, and then he went to MT, so he needed to be gritty growing up, right? Because as a Filipino guy, you're always kind of looked down on. Mm-hmm. So like if he needed to make his mark by playing defense, and then I guess his defensive capabilities stuck with him through the years.
Mm-hmm. What do you guys feel like in terms of looking back at the whole game, since you guys were able to watch it again? What are some of the things that you guys felt like you did well during the game? And executed really well.
So some things we executed really well was our defense on Brandon. Like mm-hmm. obviously we're not gonna stop him. Like he's a great force down low, mm-hmm. but the way we defended him, the way we sent different matchups towards him, the way we double teamed him, and the way we just shocked him, mm-hmm. I think that was a great work for us. Some other things that we could have worked on was possibly our conditioning. As you see, if you watch the tape, like there's a lot of us walking, including myself. Yeah, we're definitely out of shape, but. Towards that, our defense is what really I was proud of for our team and what we stick towards.
Yeah. But about walk us through the final, I guess, 2 or 3 minute stretch of that game, because you guys were down the whole game. Walk us through, like, kind of the play-by-play. How did it happen? I don't know if you guys remember still, because it's a great win. So walk us through what kind of happened through, and, like, how did you guys end up winning the game at the end?
Okay. I'll start with that Brandon 3. It was a Jasper Brandon pick and roll, and then Brandon got open for three and he hit it. So big three, they're up five.
Yeah.
I'm like, all right, a lot of time still. So I don't know what we've been doing the whole game. We don't really have any sets. It was just like we look for mismatches because we have a great pick and roll maestro right here, and all the other guys, they know how to play off that. So we just look for the mismatches, and we just send that guy to screen and roll, and then we worked off that.
Mm. I saw like a key layup there. You got the and one as well. And Mark, what were you telling your players when in those huddles when you're down five and you're about to lose a game, especially that game when it has so much meaning to Fil-Act? What are you telling your guys?
Well, I just always try to be positive, right? Like
he was yelling. I'm joking.
I can hear him like from the back. Yeah.
Yelling in a positive manner, you know? Because right, in a basketball game, there's what 300, 400 plays. Yeah. So one thing I always want to say is, guys, just next play. So when I say next play, they know. Just like to move on, get the next play. Like you can't worry about something that happened in the past. You just gotta keep going forward and stay positive.
And Mark's a calm guy.
Yeah,
I was recording.
The way he coached, he reminded me kind of when Dwayne talks. Dwayne came to our show a week ago.
Dwayne Pedro,
he talks about like you know just the calmness in coaching, so that you don't freak out your players. They don't get as anxious and nervous. Mm. So I saw a little bit of that when we were broadcasting.
I think it also resides with the team. It reflects on the coach. So when the coach is calm, he knows that we're gonna come up. The players have that belief as well, like, okay, coach believes in us, we believe in ourselves, and the fact that he doesn't get mad at us when we mess up, he doesn't sub us out, he believes in us, makes us believe in the team as well.
Okay, I agree too, right?
Yep, sure.
Yeah, I mean, last thing, because we're almost right out of time, but I want to go straight to your game, like, in terms of how did you know that it was time for you, not really to take over, but to kind of, you know, orchestrate and run the offense and kind of decide the past 3 or 2 minutes of that game? What made you decide, and what are the things in your head kind of going through the whole time?
Like you said, we were struggling the whole game. Yeah. So I knew that I had to step it up a notch, as I wasn't having the best game, as you guys could see. So basically, I just had to take the game in my control. I knew that, like you guys know, I'm a point guard, so I like to take control of the game. I like to take control of the pace. So once I could do that consistently throughout the game, I knew that I could execute plays where we could get baskets, we could get fouls to get the momentum in our favor. And I think I executed pretty well.
Mm-hmm. And that game winning, I guess, you know, bucket, to kind of walk us through, like, in your head, how did you kind of approach that? Because it was unexpected. We were even up in the stands when we were, like, broadcasting the game when you passed it to Region for that layup. what was going through your mind, or maybe you got some a little bit from him, what was going through his mind too?
So basically we had a inbounds play that Mark drew up, but it kind of messed up as their defense played really well. So I had to just get the ball so we wouldn't get a 5-second inbound violation. Mm-hmm. So I got in the corner and basically I was trying to get away from the 5-second count.
Yeah.
So I just tried to get up to the top and do my best to just bring the time down a little bit, waste some time, see what the defense was giving us. They were playing me really tight. Yeah. So I seen Regine had a mismatch. Yeah. So I asked Regine to come for the to do a pick and roll with me. Mm-hmm. They did an automatic switch, which was I was expecting. So I just wasted some time, and he was really pressuring me. Daniel Valilla, went to high school with him. Shout out to him. So yeah, he was playing me really tight, and I know his game. So no offense, I knew I could get by him. Yeah. And then, but he played really good defense, and I knew that all the defenders would be looking at me.
Yeah.
So once I knew that, I told Regine to go back door. Yeah. We made a little eye contact, and that's when he went. I seen him for the back door, just gave him the ball. And I knew he'd finish it. Regine's one of the best finishers I know. Yeah. Shout out Jelly Fam. And he finished, and we got the win.
Wow, that's amazing.
That adjustment on the fly from their MVP and the MVP coach and the MVP team, man.
Shout out to you guys. I mean, congrats again for the win. That was a gritty grind.
Yeah,
it was a good game. You know, come back from behind win. Great coaching from you. It's a great play for the end. And you know, great team for 25 for Life, putting up a great match. Sure. And Fil-Act for organizing the whole league as well, right? Mm-hmm. So.